हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई थिंक एवरीवन आर फाइन देयर। सो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश ग्रामर क्लास। सो इन द ग्रामर सेशन वी वेर देयर इन द डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच। इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच यू माइट बी फेमिलियर विद ऑल द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस ऑफ डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच। देन आई हैव रिलीज्ड the supporting video for the first video and I hope everyone have watched it. So student, don't miss out any videos. If you see in between the videos, then there will be some doubts, then there will be some confusion regarding the grammar. So it shouldn't happen with you all. So you should watch each and every videos which were uploaded there in the group in a chronological manner. Understood? So this is what you have to do. So student, in today's video we are going to learn a very most and the important topic, which it is how to convert direct speech into indirect speech. Yes, how to convert direct speech into indirect speech. So it is a supporting video for the first video, and here we are going to discuss many examples, okay, and with the particular rules which were given there in the first video, and I hope everyone have written it in your grammar notebook. So student, make a pakka notes of each and everything in your grammar notebooks, okay. Try to revise it, okay, once a 3 days or once a 4 days, so it will remain in your brain till eternity. So it should happen with everyone. So try to revise all these kind of things each and every day. So student, let's begin with the supporting video, and here the direct and indirect speech and the conversion of direct speech into indirect speech we are going to learn with the help of an animated video, a clear animated video. So watch the video thoroughly from the beginning till last and don't give up in between. Understood? So let's begin and let's be started with the animated video regarding conversion of direct speech into indirect speech. So student, here we have, okay, an animated video regarding
this video
regarding the conversion of direct speech into indirect speech, and it is a part 2, a supporting video. So student, watch it till the end. All right, fine. So let's begin and let's get started. So here what we have to remembering what we learned in previous video. Yes, in the previous video what you have learned, okay, which was a supporting video. So direct speech is a narration. Okay, what it is? It is a narration. Let's begin. What is a narration? See, act of reporting the words of speaker is called narration. This is what the indirect speech do. Yes or no? Might be a person says something, a message in the inverted comma, and it is narrated by another person, then it is called indirect speech. Here, this narration, this reporting the words of speaker is divided among two ways, which is direct speech and another one is indirect speech. So here, what are the direct speech and what is the direct speech? Direct speech is actual words are quoted in double inverted comma, or it is enclosed in inverted commas. It is enclosed in inverted commas. So this is what you can know about direct speech. And what is indirect speech? So student, see here thoroughly. See, actual words are transformed. What is indirect speech? Actual words are transformed. See here, and it is not enclosed in inverted commas. So indirect speech never enclosed in inverted commas, and here the actual words are transformed, okay, with the help of the tenses, pronouns and the reported verb where inverted comma is taken away. Let's take one example for direct speech. She said to me, I am playing. उसने मुझसे कहा मैं खेल रही हूँ. I am playing. So said to is reporting verb, What it is? Reporting verb. And I am playing is a reported speech which is said by she, and it is kept in the inverted comma. So which sentence is this, student? Direct speech sentence. And here, she said to me that she was playing. When it is converted into indirect speech, it is written in this form. She said to me, that is used to remove this inverted comma. And she was playing. Okay. Where simple present taken into simple past. The change of the tense. What you have discussed in the rules. Yes or no? Let's discuss more and more about the rules and regulation. How to convert the direct speech into indirect speech with the help of many examples with the particular rules, okay, and the regulations, even the points what they have included here to convert this sentence into this sentence. So student, see, let's begin with those rules and points what they have discussed regarding direct speech and indirect speech. So let's quickly revise direct speech and indirect speech. Okay, so first thing what you have to do, see here, things you should know, the things we should know while converting the direct speech into indirect speech. So what are these things? So these things are called concepts. Let's call them concept. So first one is subject and object. First one is subject and object. We should know what is the subject and what is the object in the sentence. Second one is first person, second person, and third person. We should know about this. And the third concept is tense. And third concept is tense. Okay. What we have discussed in the first video about the rules and regulation of direct into indirect speech. So again repeating, first one is subject and object. Every sentence have its subject and object. Subject may be in the sense of plural, and object is what subject do. Understood? So here let's discuss about this subject and object. Here Sazia said to John. Sazia said to John. So Sazia is a subject and John is a object. So what Sazia did? She said to. So what is the activity of Sazia? She said. She told something. All right. So who is the subject? Sazia is a subject and John is a object. Okay. This is what we have discussed about subject and object. Let's discuss now about first person, second person, and third person. So what is a first person? Here, for the first persons, we have to memorize the point of view. So here is a point of view regarding first person, second person, and third person. See, first person, second person, third person, okay, divided among point of view. So in the English grammar, there are only three persons, first, second, third. You might will tell me, no sir, I know 10 person, I know 100 person. Hey, it's a not a right thing. You might be knowing more than 100 and 1000 peoples, but in the English grammar, there are only three persons, first person, second person, third person. Okay, understood. Now, let's say a conversation taken place in between first person and second person, and it is not heard or it is not listened by third person. Then what happens? Okay, this first person told something to second person, and he told to the second person a message. A message is only audible to the second person. If this second person wants to tell the message of first person to the third person, then it is modified according to many ways. And the first person is always used in the sense of I, second you, and the third person he, she, it, they. Understood? So here we have one chart of first person, second person, third person. So student, quickly revise. In the first person you will get I, we, and the second person you will get you, and the third person you will get he, she, it, they, etc. Understood? So here we have tense. So in the tense, time at which the action is performed is called tense. What it is? Time at which the action is performed is called tense. The tense is further divided among three parts, which are the present, past, and future. Again, I am repeating, present, past, and future. So here, when. Let's say here simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous are the four forms of this tenses. Which one? Let's say simple present and present continuous, present perfect and present perfect continuous, or simple past, okay, simple past continuous, past perfect continuous, and these are the forms of the tenses. So here things you should know, we have revised this one, this tense, okay, first person, second person, third person, and the first beginning one, subject and object. So these are the things we should know, okay, while converting the direct speech into indirect speech. Okay, now students, let's quickly revise the six steps we have to take care. And the first step among the six step is to identify. What do you mean by identify? We should identify the sentence, which kind of sentence it is. Is it a reported speech or a direct speech or it is indirect speech? So identifying first, so what is the subject in the sentence, what is the object in the sentence, and which is the reporting verb, okay, and which person is used in the sentence, like first, second, third person. So which person is used among these persons in the sentence. Then last we have to look over which tense is used, okay, in the direct speech. So this all kind of things should be identified perfectly. So it is a first part of the rule. Then second thing what we have to see, we should change the reported verb. So how to change the reported verb or reporting verb? See, change of RV. So RV we can say in a journal sense, Rashtra Vidyalaya, or a reported verb. See, said to is a reported verb, can be written as told. Said is written as said. Say to written as tell, and says to written as tells. Okay, and then so this is called change of reported verb, changing of reported verb into given statements, what we have seen in the previous slide. Then replace with that. So we have to replace this inverted comma with the help of that, what we have discussed in the first video. Okay, and this is whatever the message given in the sentence, okay, it should be replaced by the that, okay, then inverted comma should be taken out by that. Okay, and the fourth step is to change of pronoun. What it is? Change of pronoun. So how we can change the pronoun? See, if the message is in the form of first person, while reporting we have to bring it in the form of third person. Here change of pronoun. See, first person is their subject, okay, subject. Then second person is their object. If the first person is subject and the second person is object, then the third person, if it is a matter of third person, then there will be no change, okay, he or she can be written as it is. If the first person is in subject, second person is an object, then we have to bring this first person into second, third person, second person into third person. If it is a matter of third person, there will be no change, and it is well revised in the form of S-O-N, son. Okay, subject, object, and no change. This is also we should take care. I am repeating once again, in the sentence, if first person, it is converted into third person, second person converted into third person, and third person, there will be no change while writing the direct speech into indirect speech. So, and what is the fifth step among these all six steps? Fifth is change of tense. Change of tense. See here, reporting verb is in past tense. If the reporting verb is in past tense, then we have to change it into, okay, change it into, let's say, change it into, okay, some past continuous or past perfect tense. Here, RS is not universal truth or habit. If there is universal truth, it should be written as it is. Okay, let's discuss of RV is in past tense or another tense. Let's say present tense. If simple present is there, it should be written into simple past. If present continuous is there, it should be written into past continuous. If present perfect is there, it should be written into past perfect. If present perfect continuous is there, then it should be written into past perfect continuous. So student, memorize it thoroughly. Now comes to the past form of the reporting verb. If the reporting verb is in simple past, it should be written into past perfect. If it is in the form of past continuous, it should be written into past perfect continuous. And it should be written in, if it is in past perfect or past perfect continuous, then there will be no change. Each and everything should be written as it is. Okay, if it comes the matter of future, the will, shall can be written as would or should, what we have discussed in the rules. Okay, this is what should be taken care, because these are called models, and models are the expectation, imagination, okay, probability, some future expectation can be written, can be taken into the models. So can be written as could, or may be written as might or ought to be or might be. Understood, student? So here there should be change of the tense while converting the direct speech into indirect speech. Now comes to the last step, okay, while converting the direct speech into indirect speech. What it is? Update time specific words. What it is? Update time specific words. We should update the time also, because while converting the direct speech, a reporting verb of the direct speech, into the indirect, we should write the whole sentence into a past. Yes or no? This is what the tenses say. So we have to bring some time specific also, which is updating the time specific words. Let's say, for example, how we can update this time specific words. Let's quickly revise. See, here can be written as there. Tomorrow can be written as the next day. And today can be written as, yes, the that day. And yesterday can be written as, okay, the previous day. Yes or no? Then this can be written as that, and even now can be written as, okay, what? Then, all right. And here tonight can be written as that night. Understood? These time specific words can be changed into according to the given table, according to the set solutions. So student, here we have discussed the 6 steps we should memorize while changing the direct speech into indirect speech. Okay, so here we have discussed subject and object, reporting verb, first, second, third person tense. So it is a work of identifying. Okay, it is a work of identifying. Second, we have discussed change of reported verb. See, said to, told, said, say to, tell, says to, tells. Then third, we discussed replaced with that. What it is? Replace with that. So here we have to replace the inverted comma with the help of that. Then we have discussed the change of pronoun. So first person is in subject, second person is in object, and in the third person there will be no change. Then we discuss the change of tense also. Okay, if the reporting verb is in the past, simple past, then it will be converted into, okay, past continuous tense. Understood? Then we discuss update time specific words. So these all words should be taken care while writing the indirect speech. So how we have to change the time specific also. Now let's quickly revise some examples how to convert the direct speech into indirect speech with various and understandable examples. Okay. Yes, here example we have. She said to me, I am playing football with you now. So student, which form of the reporting verb is used here in the sentence? The reporting verb is present continuous tense. So the whole sentence is in the form of present tense. So she is here subject, me is here object, said to is here reporting verb or Rashtra Vidyalaya. Then comes, I am playing football with you now. So I is here first person, you is here second person. Okay, then am playing, which form of the tense it is? Am playing, can you guess? Am playing is here the present tense. Which? The present tense. It is a present continuous tense here, present continuous tense. And now is a time. What it is? Now is a time. So here let's change this direct speech into indirect speech. So first, what we will do, what we have discussed, first we have identified, okay, all these kind of things. So the second step, we have change of reporting verb. So said to can be well written into told. So the third step, we have replaced inverted comma with the help of that. So we are replacing here. She said to me, Dad. So this inverted comma is taken out by Dad. Then we will take fourth step, what we have discussed. Change of pronoun. What it is? Change of pronoun. All right. How we can change the pronoun? See, I can be changed into she, and here I is changed into she, and you, second person, can be changed into, yes, in which form? You can be changed into me. Yes, what it is? Me. Understood. Second person can be changed into me. Then we have the fifth steps, change of tense. What? Change of tense. How we can change the tense? See, the whole message is in the form of present continuous tense. If it is present continuous, then which form of the tense we have to use here while changing? Am playing can be changed into was playing. The present continuous is changed into past continuous. See, am playing changed into was playing. So was playing is a past continuous. So student, go through the tense table because it is very important. Then comes the change of time words. So now can be changed into then. Now can be changed into then. This is what a very important part. How we have taken such a beautiful example and we have applied how we can change by this rules. Okay, by this rules and regulation while changing this direct speech into indirect speech. Now, she told me that she was playing football with me then. So here we got the answer. Okay, she told me that she was playing football with then by applying those all rules over the question. So another example, let's see towards another example. Here, Ram said, Shyam, I started a new job. So Ram is a subject here. Okay, Shyam is an object, said is a reporting verb. I is a first person, started here, simple past. Okay, job is here an activity which is done by the Ram. So first we have to identify, Ram is subject, said is reporting verb, Rashtriya Vidyalaya. Shyam is an object, I is a first person. Who is he? He is first person, started, which form of the verb it is? It is simple past. What it is? Simple past. Understood. First we have identified, and here you will not get the third person. Now comes to the change of reporting verb or change of reporting verb. So said can be written into said. It is written into as it is said. Okay, then what we have to do? We have to replace inverted comma with that. So these inverted comma of direct speech should be converted into indirect speech by putting that. Okay, here Ram said Shyam dad. Ram said Shyam dad. Yes, that we have used instead of this inverted comma. Now we have to bring the changes over change of pronoun. How we can change the pronoun? See, here I is written as he. First person can be converted into third person. See, I is converted into he. Alright, so here we have the tense form is started. So it is well written into simple past. So change of pronoun is over. Then comes the another step. What it is? Change of tense. What it is? Change of tense. So here started can be well written into started is a simple past. So we have to change it into which one? Yes, tell me quickly which one? It is past continuous or a past perfect or past perfect continuous? Yes, the started is well written into had started, which is past perfect, had started. Understood, student? Very simple. It is not written continuous. It should be written into, okay, past perfect tense, which is had started. All right, student. So student, here we have the sentence, Ram said Shyam that he had started a new job. All right. So student, this is what we have discussed, some two important examples, and we have converted the direct speech into indirect speech. So student, today I am going to leave many examples related to the direct and indirect speech. So you have to solve it there in your notebooks and send me back in the WhatsApp where I am going to check it. So after all, we have completed the portion direct speech into indirect speech in three videos, okay, in three classes. So now I will give you homework. You have to write and convert the direct speech into indirect speech and send me back there in the WhatsApp, where I'm going to check it and how much you have acquired with the help of the video. If you have any doubts, you can ask me by calling or texting a message, okay, in the group. Understood, student? This is what you have to do it out here. So student, for the time being, watch this video, okay, from the beginning till last, and make proper notes. And take care, stay happy, stay healthy, and do your work on time, and send me there in the WhatsApp, and where we are going to check it. Okay, student, for the time being, take care, have a nice day.